Good morning, everyone. We're talking about congruence at triangles. Let's go to write two triangles that theta are corresponding, that have corresponding congruent part. If two triangles are congruent, that means that we need to identify pair or corresponding congruent part. We have here a pair of triangles. They are given what are the corresponding size and what are the corresponding angles. Here we have the problem say that the triangle are congruent. Okay. And they gave here, if we have here, you see this side, we have line here, we have here this, in the other triangle, we have here this side, with one line here. That means that these two side are gonna be corresponding, and these two sides of the triangle is gonna be congruent. Okay, let me call that one triangle one, triangle two, just only to help us. Okay, so we can say that one, and here you see these two lines here, that means that this side here is gonna be corresponding to this side here from the triangle one, and this side here from the triangle one is gonna be corresponding to the side of the triangle two because it has three lines. The same way the angle is gonna be corresponding or congruent to, you see you have one like one line here, a circular line. On that one, that means that this angle is going to be corresponding to this angle. Let me call this, they call here angle D, angle F, angle E. The other triangle, angle V, angle A, and angle C. Okay, this means that angle F is going to be corresponding or congruent to the angle C. Okay, let's go to C. Okay, for the angle one, the angle C is gonna be congruent to the angle F. If we're going, let's go. You see here. Let's go for the side that have one line. We're going to go to the angle A in order to go in order. And you're gonna be easy to get the answer. Okay. Angle A. The angle A is gonna be, if we go for the angle F in here, we have angle F in here. We are going for the side that have one line here. You see? We're gonna get angle E. That's what gonna be corresponding. Later we're going to the angle V, that is gonna be for the line that is had two lines here. That should be angle V is congruent to the angle E. Sorry, to the angle D. Okay. Right now, we're going to check the congruence about the size. We say that this side here, that have one line here, we call CA, C, the same in CA, is going to be congruent is coming for C, that's congruent. That way, if I call CA, I have to call this side, this semicircle FE, because it's coming from this angle is congruent, C is congruent to F, so I start for F and C in order to not get confused. Okay, FE. This side here is going to be congruent to this side. This side is going to be congruent to this side. That will be the same in line, the same in line AB. It's congruent to ED. And right now we have the semicircle BC is going to be congruent to the semicircle DF. Okay. Right now, we have here the corresponding angles, the congruence of the corresponding angle, and the congruent and the corresponding size. You see, we have to write to say that the congruent triangle we can call CAB. If we call this triangle CAB, we must to say that it's congruent to the triangle in the same way. If we call CAB, we have to say FED, triangle F, E, D. Okay. If we call this triangle in another way, let me tell you, B, A, C, you have to say that this triangle is congruent to D, E, F in the same way. D, E, F. Okay? That should be the answer.